Phil.
Yeah.
Question.
Go.
Where did you graduate high school?
I went to Greater Nanticoke Area High School in Nanticoke, Pennsylvania, not Nanticoke, Maryland. We say Nanticoke, but
Nanticoke?
I don't know. Nanticoke?
A hyperactive babysitter.
Nanticoke.
Yeah.
Our school mascot was the Trojan.
This is our coked up nanny. I went to McDonough. I graduated from McDonough.
Wow. Well, first of all,
1997.
I would bet it's probably not the McDonough we're all thinking
That's
about.
That's the damn problem, Phil, because I went to Maurice J. McDonough in Pomfret, Maryland, in the middle of the swamp. Okay, you can major in beer brewing and running from your stepdad.
Yeah, yeah. You couldn't pass the test to get into kindergarten, probably.
Hurtful. I, for years, have dealt with the McDonough versus McDonough bit, where there is the McDonough I went to, and then there is the Institute of Higher Learning on McDonough Road in Owings Mills, Maryland. Private coeducational PK through 12 college preparatory school. For years, I've had this bee up my bonnet that my high school, which I would argue to guess I might be one of the more successful people to ever walk out of those swamp moss-covered halls. Yeah. You always smell damp in there. I cannot get them for the life of me. I want to go back. I want to talk to the kids. I want to say what's up. All right. I loved career days. I wanted to do one.
So why don't you?
I have tried. I have been. Well, my advances have been rebuffed.
What?
My advances have been rebuffed.
Want to think of you as a 98 Rock morning show
host.
Yeah,
you say that they're embarrassed by you?
Maybe they're disgusted by me.
Yeah.
Okay?
They want nothing to do with you. They're distancing themselves.
Who the hell else has been through that?
So you've never
You've
never been asked to speak to anybody there?
Never.
Did you finish high school?
I did. I did have to have
barely
my mom talk to the vice principal to let me walk because I missed a lot of days.
Really?
I could tell them what to do and what not to do. Learn from my mistakes.
Why did you miss a lot of time in high school?
I discovered
Were you
weed
screwing around?
And breasts and skateboarding.
Yeah, weed and vagina, Phil.
And the Sony PlayStation. Yeah, I veered off the path a little bit, and then I found the Lord. Now I walk in his light. But I'm done. I'm sick of trying. I'm over. So I've gone on a bit of a crusade behind the scenes recently. These guys are ready to pull their ears off having to hear me talk about this. Phil, you're familiar in like pop culture. When someone will go speak at like the Yale commencement, the Harvard commencement, the graduation at Princeton, some institute of higher learning.
You get an honorary degree.
Yes,
an honorary doctorate.
Exactly.
Well, I would like to calmly, respectfully, with all the dignities that the institution of McDonough School deserves therein, politely request an honorary high school degree from the McDonough School because my McDonough has turned its back on me.
And so?
We might have.
Stop it.
Made progress yesterday.
Ooh.
Ooh.
The reach of this show sometimes shocks me. When we have someone from NASA that says they're listening, someone that's a neurosurgeon that says they're listening. I got a very, very sweet text from our own Justine. She's our videographer. She's the person in charge of making
I love her, by the way. She is great.
Is
love
overworked,
her.
Underpaid. She's truly one of the greatest people in here. Well, she says that she had a friend of hers reach out and say, hey, they graduated from the McDonough School. They graduated from this McDonough School you're all high on. She says, hey, I got the number right here for you. Reach out and see what you can do. So I reached out to this individual. I will just say Ms. Collins. Thank you for reaching out.
Okay.
Ms. Collins recently was married there. Her father graduated from there. By God, I think there's a building or maybe a wing named after this family at the McDonald's.
Wow.
School. And she and her ilk are apparently big fans of the show. Thank you. And she said, I will place a call. I will see what I can do.
Gonna place a call.
I received this text message in return yesterday.
Wow, that is a lengthy text message.
Yes, it is. Okay. I said, I am looking to, as part of a bit on the radio, I would like to be given an honorary degree from the McDonough School because my McDonough has turned its back on me. And she said, I'll reach out. But this is a serious school. You know, this place is for real.
Yeah, I don't really see this happening.
Neither did I.
I don't see them entertaining this at all.
I received this.
See, I think we can make this happen.
Let's see. Phil, I got this text yesterday from her. So she says, I asked earlier about your request, and my father was the one that said, this is serious business. He works at and went to McDonough along with his entire family. His uncle, Fabius, received an honorary diploma from the McDonough School when he was 90-something years old. Listen to this story. Fabius went to the McDonough School in the 1930s and 40s, but was expelled for skipping class and running home from school because he was helping his mother, who was alone and struggling to make ends meet. She brought it up with her dad. The story still brings her father to tears talking about it. It really tugs on an emotional cord, the tale of this guy who they were just following the letter of the law. You miss school, you get expelled. But then they found out the reasons he was. It was like, oh, you were stealing from work. Yes, but I was stealing bread to feed my family. So this guy, Fabius, received an honorary degree at the age of 90. Now, this guy was also helping out a single mom and was probably cut from a better cloth, principally
exactly.
From me. But they
and he was on his deathbed when they did it.
I can be on my deathbed if that's what's required.
You're not on your deathbed.
I can be.
You're not running home to help some poor mom.
Hannah, deathbed.
You're just upset that your school wants nothing to do with you.
You know who I think you could pick up the phone and call to make this happen?
Who's that?
Former National Security Advisor to the United States, John Bolton.
That's not going to happen.
He
we
just
don't
received
have a line.
The ire of the president. He is a graduate of the McDonough School.
Shut your slut mouth.
No.
Really? He went to Bolton? Really?
Yes,
Bolton went to McDonough?
He went to McDonough.
Okay. I'm going to make
I
this
think
one.
You should get a call there and just say, your mustache is better than mine, and you make the phone call.
My mustache is weak. I'm going to make this final little plea, and we're going to leave it at this until there's a movement. Until there's movement, good or bad. Thank you again, Miss Collins.
I don't
very
think
sweet
you
woman.
Deserve it.
Would you stand beside me?
I'm trying.
Damn effort?
I'm trying.
It doesn't sound like it when you yell on the air, I don't think you deserve it.
I mean, hearing
it's
that
not
guy's,
trying.
Hearing that
it's
guy's
knocking
story.
Knocking my leg out from under me.
Hearing that guy's story.
You went to a fantastic school. They're proud of you there.
Did you go there? They don't give a rat's ass about
public
me.
High school. Bethpage.
Public, baby.
Invite your boy back, okay? He's one of the most successful people to ever come out of Bethpage. Have him speak to the Litlands, all right? I'm ready to change McDonough allegiances.
Hannah, where do you stand on this?
I think there's a chance.
Thank you.
No, but
Hannah.
Do you think it should be done?
Of course I do. That sounds hilarious. Why? I don't understand. What's the downfall? What's the downside of it?
Well, I would be probably bringing a stink to their organization. I would be bringing a level of murk and filth
for
to
diversity.
Scott's on now. I like that angle. Thank you. Plus, I like their uniforms.
Hey, I like your outfit.
They're dressed nicely. People in my school were wearing clothes that their parents bought them with camel bucks.
I'm just sitting here looking at photos of McDonough.
It's gorgeous,
in the
right?
facilities.
It's
and
gorgeous.
I think you should just be happy where you came from. Be happy with your McDonough.
You know, there is a certain, mm-mm. yeah, there's a certain, mm-mm. like, appeal to that. I went to McDonough. Do you have a sweatshirt that says McDonough from your high school?
Do you think we make clothing at McDonough?
Everybody
certain
makes clothing.
Classrooms
Come on.
Didn't have electricity. All right.
What do you want with these hoity-toities?
Just
yeah.
want to be amongst them. Because I'm just, it's the same way I'm tired of spelling my name my entire life. Schlegel? Slargle? Schlegel. Slargle? How do you spell that? With an F? Yes, with an F, F-head. The same thing with...
Your last name's not Jakubowski. Okay?
Oh, that, so you're with me there. So the same way I tell people from around here, I went to McDonough, and they go, ooh. And I go, no, the one that's in a swamp. Oh. I would love to be able to kind of, in a roundabout way, say, yes, I am a graduate from McDonough.
We just had a mystery caller that said that John Rollo graduated from McDonough.
There Excuse you go. Me? There's your
yeah.
end.
John!
There's your end!
You get me into the McDonough
Wait,
School as an
Rollo
honorary degree.
Went to McDonough?
Yeah, that guy's a businessman. He's a warrior. He's a mogul. He's a father. He's a husband. A lover. Oh, I would love that. Oh, John, you're my in. We'll go with Bolton. We'll go with Rollo. Whoever else, if you went to the McDonough School, tell them I would like
you
to
got,
be.
Listen, it says I will withhold any future donations to McDonough until they give you a degree, or you can just have mine. So here's another person saying that.
How about
McDonough alumni here, we would love to have you as honorary alum.
I would be moved.
How about let's see, Evan Taubenfeld.
Who the hell is that?
Recording artist, professional pop singer and songwriter, Avril Lavigne's lead guitarist from the spring 2002-2004.
Okay, here we go. We're cooking with gas now.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.